Hello guys, in this video we'll talk about labeled break. So when you talk about a break statement in Java, so you know we have C programming, C++ and Java, so we are using this statement break at in every programming language, right? Maybe it's C or C++ or Java. Now whenever you use a break statement, we can use break statement in switch, we can use break statement in any loop, maybe for loop or while loop or do while loop. So whenever you have, let's say, two loops, so we have two loops here, let me go in this way, let me create a loop which starts with 1, it will go till 4 and I will say increment, and let me use one more loop here and say int j equal to 1 and j less than equal to 4. Basically we'll try to print a pattern here. Now, so how we print pattern? So we'll simply say print a star here, say space, and then here we'll print a new line. So when you write this code, it will basically print a square shape, a square stars, you know, something in this way. If I run this, this is the output, right? But let's say, so how it's working, so the number of rows is counted by this I, the number of columns is defined by this j, right? Now let's say I don't want to go beyond the value of I, let's say 3. So I have to check if my I value is 3. So what we can simply do is we can say break. Now this break is called as, this is your unlabeled break statement. Okay. So what it means, whenever you use this unlabeled break statement, it will break the inner loop. Since we have two loops here, this is your inner loop and this is your outer loop. So whenever you use a break statement here, it will only break the inner loop. Okay, so if I run this, the output will be, so the value of I will be 1. So this loop will run 4 times, it will print a star 4 times. Once this loop is done, it will go to a new line, so with 4 stars. Again, it will print those 4 stars since my I value is 2. And then when my I value is 3, this will say break, which will break this loop. Okay. And once you break this loop, it will print a new line. So it will print 2 stars and a blank row. And then again, it will continue with this, because whenever you use break, it will only break the inner loop. So outer loop will still work and you will be getting the 4th row. So if I run this now, you can see it's skipping the 3rd line, but it's printing the 4th line. So it is breaking only the inner loop, not the outer loop. Now I want to break this outer loop. So what we can do is, we can just label it. So we'll say, I will use my name to label it. So I will say Navin. So I'm labeling this for loop here. So how to use label? So we can define any keyword or any identifier, which is, let's say, Navin, and a colon. So colon defines its label. And then we can simply say break Navin. So what it will do is it will only break the outer loop. So it will break the outer loop. So since outer loop is breaked, you cannot execute the inner loop, right? And now if you run this, it will print only 2 rows. Since there's a break for the outer loop, it will break the whole system, and then we're getting only 2 rows. And this type of break now will be called as labeled break statement. Okay, so we can also use label with break statement in Java. So that is from this video. So for further videos, do subscribe and thank you so much for watching.